Project managers are always looking for a number of ways how they can optimize their schedule. Also, they want to know where is the scheduling flexibility available so that they can utilize it to cover up unforeseen situations as well as risks. Schedule network analysis is a wide range of tools and techniques that project managers can deploy to use to come up with a viable schedule model. One of that technique is the critical path method. There are various others such as critical chain method, resource leveling, simulation, fast tracking, crashing, use of schedule tool. In this video, we are going to study specifically critical path method. Critical path method actually is used for two purposes. We want to know the minimum time it takes to complete the project, and we want to know where is the scheduling flexibility available, which activities have the float actually. So how we can determine it, we need to understand what is the concept of early start date, late start date, early finish date, and late finish date. In this method, also we are going for a few assumptions. We are considering that the resources that are needed to do the job will be available for the duration of the activities. And also, we need to make an assumption that the duration estimates are deterministic. Scheduling flexibility can be also known as float. Float is of three types. We are referring to total float as amount of delay that an activity can avail without impacting the whole project. So amount of delay, an activity, amount of time an activity can be delayed without impacting whole project or project end date. That is total float. Also, it is called as float or it is called as slack. Then we have free float. An activity can be delayed without delaying the early start date of successor activity. So free float is the amount of time an activity can be delayed without impacting the early start date of successor activity. So it is between two activities. And then we have project float. Project float is the amount of time a project can be delayed without impacting the imposed deadline from the customer. All right. So how we can actually understand and calculate float? First, we need to have our activities list, and we should have the relationships well defined. And also we should have the duration as we said. And then we can generate the precedence diagramming method, and using that we can come up with our network, schedule network diagram. So in this example, you can see we have generated our schedule network diagram using activity on node or precedence diagramming method. And now we shall see this rectangular box over here. In the center, there is an activity, and then you see this small box where it is mentioned the duration. So what we did, we have mapped the duration of these activities after plotting the schedule network diagram. And the idea here is that we need to calculate the longest path from start till end. So we see various paths are there, actually seven paths are there when you move from start till end, right? And we need to determine duration of each path. So let's begin. The path one is start, C, A, T, and N. So let's calculate the duration. C takes 6 days and A takes 7 days. So that makes 13. And then we have T, which takes 2 days, that make it to 15. So the network path start C, A, T, and N takes 15 days. Then we have start C, A, R, end. C takes, as we say, C takes 6 days, A takes 7 days, which is 13, and then R takes 3 days, which is 16. So duration becomes 16 days. Then we have start B, A, T, end. That takes 13 days. We have B, A, R, end, which takes 14 days. We have P, A, R, end, which takes 13 days. We have P, A, T, end, which takes 12 days. And we have P, U, N, end, which takes 13 days. All right. So we determined which one is the longest path, which is start C, A, R, end, which has having 16 days duration. So this is our critical path. The longest path in our schedule network diagram is the critical path, and all the activities on the longest path will be critical activities. It doesn't mean other activities are not important and only these are important. No, but it does mean that these activities do not have any scheduling flexibility available. So what we are saying is they have zero float. They cannot be delayed. A single day of delay on these activities will delay the project by that much amount of the time. If you delay it by one day, the whole project will be delayed by one day. All right. So what we need to know else is what is the early starts and early finish dates, right? So we need to determine float. Before that, we need to determine what is the earliest start date of an activity and earliest finish date of an activity. The method that we can use is forward pass. Forward pass method, actually, we use a formula for forward pass method and we calculate the early start and early finish dates. Let's see the same example over here. And in this case, we have the formula for early finish date, which is equal to early start plus duration minus one. So assume that your project is starting on day one, and day one concurrently C, activity B and activity P are starting. So earliest an activity C can start is day one. Similarly, earliest an activity B can start is day one. Earliest an activity P can start is day one. All right. So if you have early start date of C, how we can find out early finish? By this formula. Early finish is equal to early start plus duration minus one. So we say one plus six, which is the duration, is seven, and then minus one is six. All right. From where this minus one comes? So we can use the rule of thumb. We calculate one day. So let's say you are starting on day one, which is Monday, right? So you need to count six. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So that makes six, right? So activity is for 6 days, right? So it has to be six, which is the finish day. It is finishing on sixth day. So one plus six will become seven. We have to subtract is one to make it six. That's why we are having. All right. So we will proceed with the activity B. Activity B makes it one plus four is equal to five, minus one will be four. And then activity P will be one plus three, four, minus one will be three. So we are having, now we have determined the early start and early finish dates of activity C, B, and P, right? All right, so that's done. Now let's move to the activity A. Activity A, we are having a convergence. Here, many activities are converging to this activity, which means that activity A cannot start until activity C, B, and P finishes. Now let's say, what is the early finish of activity P? 3 days. Activity B, 4 days. Activity C, 6 days, which means we have to wait until day six so that activity P as well as B as well as C all are finished, right? So what will be the early start of activity A? The next day. So 6 day activity C, B and P are finishing, all finishing, right? And then the next day is the seventh day. So we are considering seventh day as this early start of activity A. Then we move on. From there, we have 7 plus 7 is 14, minus 1 is 13, which is the early finish date of activity A. And then, okay, let's see about activity U. Activity U depends on activity P. Activity P has early finish date as 3. So next day will be fourth day. Fourth day activity U can start. So 4 plus 4 is 8. Minus one is seven, which is the early finish date of activity U. Now let's move on to activity T. Here we have the precedence activity, which is A. A is finishing on 13th day. So very next day will be the 14th, when activity T can earliest start. Early start date will be 14. 14 plus two is 16, minus one is 15, the early finish date. All right, let's see what is happening at R. Activity R depends on activity A. Activity A is finishing on 13th. 14th will be the early start day of activity R. 14 plus 3 is 17. Minus 1 is 16. So that's 16 is the earliest activity R can finish. Then we have the last activity, which is activity N, which is dependent on activity U. Activity U is finishing on seventh day, so activity N will start earliest on 8th day. 8 plus 6 is the duration, which is 14. 14 minus 1 will be 13. So 13 will be the earliest finish date of activity N. Now, N is dependent on all three activities, activity N, activity R, activity T to finish. So which one is the longest? R is the longest, which is 16th day. So we have to wait till 16th day. So all N, R, and T are finished, and then we can end the project. So here, what we have determined? We have determined that our critical path is start C, A, R, end, and the duration is 16 days. So minimum days it required to finish the project is 16 days. And also we know the earliest start date of activity C, earliest finish date of activity C, as well as all the activities on this schedule network diagram. We have determined the earliest start date as well as the earliest finish date. Now is the time to look for the backward pass. So what backward pass can give us is the late start and late finish dates. All right, so we are moving from end of our schedule network diagram backward. So we are moving backward in our schedule, and from end date we are going to determine the latest an activity can start and latest an activity can finish. All right, so 16 is, we know, the minimum time required to finish this project, right? So we will say 16 is the latest finish date of activities T, R, and N. So 16, so then the formula is the latest finish minus duration, and then plus one. So 16 minus duration is 2, which is 14, and then plus one is 15. So our late start of activity T will be 15. Similarly, at activity R, 16 minus 3 is 13, and plus 1 is 14. And then we have activity N, 16 minus 6 is 10, plus 1 is 11. All right, so that's being done. Now let's move to activity U. Activity U, here we have activity N as the previous activity. So N earliest, so late start of N is 11, right? So when we are moving to activity U, we will go a previous day when the activity N can late finish of activity U will be 10, which will be the previous day of 11, right? So 10 minus 4, which is 6, plus 1 will be 7, will be the early late start date of activity U. And also now let's see activity A. At activity A also we have divergence. So we see two activities, R and T, and we have the late start of T as 15 and late start of R as 14. So here when we are moving backward, we have to choose the smallest of these two, 15 and 14. Which is smallest? 14. 14 minus 1 will come here, 13. So 13 is the late finish of activity A. Activity, 13 minus 7 is 6, plus 1 is 7. So we have 7 here. All right, now we will come to our activity C, B, and P. So we have 7 as the early, the late start of activity A. So activity C will be late finish of activity C will be 6. Similarly, late finish of activity B will be 6 as well. And now here another situation, P is diverging to A as well as U. So here we have similar figure, which is A has the late start 7 as well as U has the late start 7. So it doesn't matter, P will be late finish of P will be 6 day, end of 6 day. All right, so then 6 minus 3 is 3, and then plus 1 is 4 at P, as well as if you see at B, 6 minus 4 is 2, plus 1 is 3, which is the late start. And for C, 6 minus 6 is 0, plus 1 is 1. Okay, all right, so that's how we calculated the backward pass. And now the next step is the last process in this is the determining the float. All right, so how we can determine the float is through subtracting the early finish from late finish, or early start from late start. All right. So how we did it? We did it. This is the early. This is late finish, and this is early finish, right? So we subtracted. We became to know this is zero. Okay. On critical path, the good thing is that the float is zero, so we can immediately mention zero here, or we can calculate it will become zero. C, A, and R, float is zero, so whatever early start is same as late start, whatever early finish is same as late finish. All right. And now what about the other activities, such as activity B? Do we have a float? Yes. 6 minus 4 is 2, so we have 2 days of float on B. We can calculate float at B, which is 6 minus 3, which is 3. So we have 3 days of float at B. Similarly, U, we also have 10 minus 3, 3 days of float. And also 16 minus 13, on N we have a 3 days of float. And also on T we have a float of 1 day. All right, so two things here, quickly. We have a near critical path here. How, for example, start, C, A, T, and end. The duration is 15, right? Important point is only T activity has 1 day of load, which means that this is just a 1 day. 1 day can make it, a delay of 1 day can make it another critical path, right? All right, so that's important. That's why we call it a near critical path. Another point to note is here that if you have consumed, for example, the float of activity P, total float of activity P, which is 3, then you will not be left with the float for activity U or N, right? So it's your choice. You can avail on P, or you can avail on U, or you can avail on N. It depends, right? But if you have used on P, for example, if you have used on P the 3 days of float and delayed early start of P to late start, which is 4th day, which what will happen, the 4th day it is starting, it will take 3 days, it will end on day 6, right? So 4 plus 3, 7 minus 1 is 6, all right? And then activity U will start on 7th day, which is its latest start. So this will make 7 as the earliest it can start, as well as latest it can start is 7. So it will make 0 float available on U. Similarly, you will be left with no float for the activity. Then you will be left with no float for the activity N, because 7 plus 4 is 11, minus 1 is 10. So you will be left with earliest it can finish will be 10, and then you will be left with day 11, the activity N has to start. All right, so that's how we determine that the float available on activities. So what we can conclude is the critical path is the longest path. The duration of critical path is the duration of the project, the minimum possible duration of the project. And also there is no float available on the activities on the critical path, and single day of delay on any activity on a critical path will extend the project by 1 day. And yes, if a certain activity on a critical path can be expedited, similarly, the end of the project can also be expedited by that much amount. All right. Great job. I shall see you in the next lecture. If you like my video, please press the subscribe icon.